in the West and the Midwest, which meant that it was willing to undergird its white peasants from Europe with an economic floor. But not only did they give the land, they built land-grant colleges with government money to teach them how to farm. Not only that, they provided county agents to further their expertise in farming. Not only that, they provided low interest rates in order that they could mechanize their farms. Not only that, today many of these people are receiving millions of dollars in federal subsidies not to farm, and they are the very people telling the black man that he ought to lift himself by his own bootstraps. Now, this is what we are faced with, and this is the reality. Now, when we come to Washington in this campaign, we are coming to get our check.
Yo, what's good, people? We back. Had to come through, man. Had to come through because I want to talk about this clip right here real fast. You know what I'm saying? That you saw in the beginning. And I'm glad that this clip has been making its way around the internet for the past couple of years. You know, because it does nothing but help us. Like, you can, like, they can no longer just put Martin Luther King in our face and be like, oh man, nonviolence, oh dude, don't beat me up. That's basically what they're saying when they say, show Martin Luther King and say nonviolence. They just don't want to get slapped for the shit that they deserve to be slapped for. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, like this clip, he's saying, like, this goes back to the 1800s, back to when, you know, because I've been going back and forth with some wannabe supremacists on my page, right? And they keep telling me, oh no, the Irish built America. No, the Irish and the Chinese built America. And you know, truth being truth, you know, we know that's a lie. And it's like, if you go back to the 1800s when slavery was over, black people outnumbered the slaves, outnumbered the slave masters. You get what I'm saying? We're not counting the poor white trash. Poor white trash didn't matter. They were on the sideline the whole time. You get what I'm saying? It was between the slaves and the slave master. The slaves outnumbered the slave master once they've ended slavery. So that's black people outnumbering white people once they outnumbered a certain portion of white people once slavery was over. And what did they do? They said, you know what, empty out the jails in England, empty out the jails in Dutch, empty out the jails in you know, whatever European land, you know, in Ireland, yeah, empty out the jails and the mental institutions over there and bring them over here, and then we can all add up. And then, you know, the funny thing about that is a lot of them, the only ones that came over and were considered white when they got here are the ones from Dutch and England. You know what I'm saying? All them other ones, they weren't considered white when they got here. Italians, Irish people, they weren't considered white. You know what I'm saying? And so they did that only to, you know, to compete with black people so that, you know, black people don't take over. That's what they did. Why did they have to do that? Because they know that the black people's intelligence was too much for them to handle, because the black people were the reason why they were making all the money, and they were in the, off of their backs. And they said if they do that for themselves, they're going to be good, right? So then you have, you know, the 1960s where Martin Luther King is talking about. He's talking about the later immigrants, the Italians and the Irish. You know, when they come over, they get provided economic floors. They get economic programs and economic, you know, all type of stimuluses once they get here, just to protect their families and feed their families and everything like that, have a place to live. They get that. When black people were freed out of slavery, they didn't get nothing. They just cut the rope. Say, all right, y'all could go. They didn't get nothing, right? So, and then you know, we saw what we did ourselves, and every time we did it ourselves, white filthy white man just came through and burned it down or did some crazy stuff or built a highway going right through the middle, you know. So that's been going on for almost a century now. And so it's like when Martin Luther King is saying, like, yo, they gave them money. And then they didn't just give them money. They taught them how to do it. You know what I'm saying? Like, we taught them how to grow crops and stuff like that. Because, you know, they was poor, starving, and nasty before they met us. So we taught them how to grow crops. They learned what we taught them, beat us down, and then taught some other white immigrants how to grow crops, and then gave them money so that they can get a house and a farm. You know what I'm saying? So Martin Luther King, like, yo, you doing all that? Yo, next time I come up there, yo, I'm coming for the check. I'm coming for a check. I mean, that's the reason why I'm not coming up there to give no cute speech. I'm not, like, because everybody forgets that it was John F. Kennedy that said, you know, Martin, we can't have that Negro talk up here at the White House. So John F. Kennedy said, yo, you got to get Bayard to write you a cute speech, and make it for everybody. You know, that's when you have the I Have a Dream speech, which was promoted to us for about 40 years. You get what I'm saying? And so, Martin Luther King saying that we come in and get our check. They can't go around showing Martin Luther King's face unless it's about that check. This is where black people are at now. You know what I'm saying? But this is where black people are at now. We at the same point Martin Luther King was. We see you letting illegal immigrants come to this country. You provided them with health care, with free health care. You provided them with houses. You provided them with a place to stay. You provided them all type of care. Illegal immigrants that you're doing this for. So when it comes to us, we need that check. That's what Martin Luther King is saying. We need that check when you show up, when you come through. You get what I'm saying? It's the exact same thing going on what he was talking about. It's the exact same thing. But what you gonna do? You can't kill all of us. You know what I'm saying? So it's getting real nasty out here, you know, the illegal immigrant thing, you know, black people also, whatever they offer illegal immigrants, get in that line too, because, you know what I'm saying, you were here. You get what I'm saying? Casamigos. So I'm gonna go and get out of here, man. I'm out. Salute.